not looking at operating units. I'm looking at the components within the headquarters of the Philippine Navy and also the Philippine Marines. So I think there is no disagreement between Chairman Abaya and myself, because we're talking of basically the same thing. Perhaps the only issue would be the location. And I would like to stress we're talking here of equity. Even when we relocate the humbler mission areas, the press areas, it takes a while. We have to look at the question of equity, social justice, etc., etc. Even relocating maybe 5 families, we have to go through a process. More so in the case of a major service, major command like the Philippine Navy and also the Philippine Marines. By the way, the commandant of the U.S. Marine Corps is also in the Pentagon area because he's part of the Joint Chiefs. So Dudan, I can commiserate with the possible problem of Major General Dolorpino, who will have to, he will need a helicopter just to attend a meeting in the Metro Manila area. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Congressman Torres. General Dolorpino, please.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I just would like to make clear on the record of the committee that headquarters Philippine Marine Corps is never an operational headquarters. It is an administrative and logistical headquarters, just like the headquarters Philippine team. Headquarters Philippine team never operates. The combatant units or the operational units of the Philippine Marine Corps are the brigades, and they are in Pasiglan and Sulu right now. We just provide forces, we just chart the destiny of the organization. We make plans and also this for the development of the Philippine Marine Corps. It is very important for us to be near the nerve center of the armed forces. Really, it will adversely affect our operation if we will be isolated in Marine Base Ternate or any other place outside from Manila.
Thank you, General. Before I forget, let me just go back to some administrative procedures. May I ask our colleague to just move for the approval of the previous minutes.
Chairman, I do move, Chairman, to approve the minutes that are here.
Duly moved and seconded by Congressman Duvarte. Minutes of the previous meeting is here approved. So, going back to the discussions, are there additional information you would want to give us, General Abaya? With all these positions given by our guests from Philippine Marine, Philippine Navy, and the Armed Forces, what is now our direction in the BCDA on privatizing these areas?
Mr. Chairman, we are doing what we're doing because it's below. It's below. Otherwise, we will be charged with being released with our duties if we do not follow what is provided for by the law. So I think what was already mentioned by Vice President Sosa, that we have an institutional mechanism, the DND, AFP, BCDA Technical Working Group, that should work this out. That should work this out.
Thank you, General.
Chairman, thank you, Mr. Chairman. Chairman, we were just given copies of the letters previously mentioned from General Sena, then Chief of Staff, and then General Esperon, then Chief of Staff. The one from General Esperon is dated May 5, 2006, addressed to Secretary Abelino Cruz. May just ask that this be formally presented to this committee for the record, and may I stress the following from General Senga. I quote the final paragraph of his letter. Considering the importance, this is a quotation, considering the importance of PN installations, this headquarters respectfully requests that department, meaning the DNB, to make a representation to the DNR for the issuance of a new presidential proclamation declaring 106.9 hectares of PNS and 5.4 hectares of Camp Claudio as naval reservation for use of PN units in Metro Manila. And then attached a draft proclamation. And then in the letter of General Esperon, dated January 17, again, this letter talked of the need for a presidential proclamation to Secretary of National Defense to declare, again I'm quoting, the 106.9 hectare Bonifacio Naval Station and 5.4 hectare Camp Claudio as naval reservation for use of PN units in Metro Manila to put to rest the legal issues affecting both camps. And the final paragraph is, this headquarters concurs with the request of the Philippine Navy and reiterate its previous request to make representation of the DNR for the issuance of a presidential proclamation to declare PNS at Camp Claudio as naval reservation area. So this is a very clear recommendation coming from those who are most concerned about the integrity, the contiguity, and the need for coordination among the major services of the armed forces. These are very telling points, Mr. Chairman, coming from the highest ranking AFP officer at that time, no less than two of them, Chief of Staff Esperon and Chief of Staff Senga. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Congressman.
Considering that two letters have been sent by then Chief of Staff Esperon and Senga, may I know what is the action of Malacanã or the President, particularly in the approving or approving particular letters?
You said Romero, can they respond to the query of Congressman?
May you please request a question, Your Honor?
What has been the action of Malacanã on the President of the Philippines requesting these two letters? Has it been answered? Has it been decided? Or thrown in the question basket?